So you've mentioned that the women's majlis, women also have their own majlis.
Sure.
And how important is that, the role of this majlis, the women's majlis, in your opinion?
Well, I'm not specialist in the ladies' majlis, but I believe it's, and again, majlis is a place where people get together, because I think all type of people, all nationality or cultures, people do are a social people. We need to be together, and of course there are a lot of business we have to do when we are busy, but when we are free, we need to get together, and so that's where we. I think that's where ladies get together. And usually, I mean, in the neighborhoods, it's a natural matter that some people have a leadership characteristic. And these type of people are the one, usually, which will hold the majlis, and where the others will get together at that particular majlis. It doesn't have to be that particular person is a rich or poor. But the leadership characteristic do have the influence where the majlis is held. And of course, in the majlis, as my friend said here, that there's so many things happens. We discuss politics, we discuss economy, we discuss entertainment, poetry usually are said in the majlis. In the majlis, in the old time, for example, people who comes from the sea and for paradiving or for fishing or whatever. That's where they talk about the stories that they had in the last season. People who goes for falconry and hunting, they will enjoy to go together and in the majlis after the hunting season, for example, and they will talk about what happens in their trips. So that's simply what his majlis is for.
In our childhood, I remember we used to be forced to spend few hours with the elders in the majlis. Sure. Suleiman, can you give us some or tell us some stories from your
before
childhood?
I do that, I think it's important to explain here that majlis has evolved from the early days till now, as we know them in your modern houses and the different type of structured neighborhoods. Previously, majlises used to be very cozy and close to each other. The neighbors can just walk across a small sikka to get to their neighbors' houses.
What's a sikka?
A sikka is a small alley or a road between in the neighborhoods. Okay. And so the world was really small for the neighbors, and people can just access a majlis next door. Nowadays, of course, bigger houses, bigger streets, they are spread apart. And so you have to travel to certain majlises in the neighborhoods. And sometimes they are not in the neighborhoods. Sometimes if I am from Deira, I can go to Bar Dubai to attend the majlis that I know. And I think it's more interesting than other majlises. It has evolved from the early days as we know it until as we see it now. Now, yes, I think when we were younger, we were forced to sit with the elderly for a very important reason. That is to learn from the elderly, the way they behave, they sit. Even how to sit down was learned from your father and your his friends sitting there. You really have to sit like a man. And I think one of the benefits of majlises that we are touching upon now is these benefits to teach children how to behave, how to become mature, how to discuss. Even when you talk with others, you learn it from that majlis and the way people conduct themselves. So I think just to add that there is that benefit of educating the young how to shape their life later on when they grow up, and you will see us, I think, still affected by the way we used to sit with our parents and their friends in old majlises.
I am
certainly affected by it.
We learn a lot of different tribes' habits from going to, you know, we have different tribes here in the Emirates, and we learn their different habits and way of hosting the guest. I remember that when we were guests at one of the tribes in the desert in the early 70s, they would leave the majlis or the palm leaf kind of majlis built with the palm leaf, and until we finish the meal. Can you tell us, Mr. Abdulaziz, a little bit more about the past or how the majlis plays a role in exchanging ideas and learning different people's habits and
Of course, I mean, as you said, different tribes or different part of the country has a different type of habits. For example, some tribes or some groups will not eat at the same time when the guests are eating. So there is many different habits of hosting, as you said, hosting a guest. But to say Majlis in the simple way, I think we touched on it. But again, now here we're talking about who's hosting the Majlis, what is the Majlis purpose in a different time. There are Majlises just to get together and chat, and there are Majlises where more important things are discussed in. That, of course, depends on the owner of the Majlis. There are majlises where just young guys sit and play cards, talks about their adventures and things like that. And there are majlises where are very formal, and people talks about very specific and formal points that there. There are many part. I mean, sometime when there are a dispute between two men or two people, they will discuss it in the majlis, and they will agree to solve their the dispute between. I mean, they will agree on what is the other people or the other men in the majlis will recommend on solving.
And the
that
owner of the majlis or the host will be the judge then.
That's doesn't have to be. If the owner of the majlis is an older man, or he has more weight in his social group, so that's of course depends. Sometimes other people with more wise people are in the majlis, and they will respect them, and they will accept their judgment and their decision on the distribution of that problem. Of course, again, as I it was mentioned before, that majlis has a purpose. When we are kids, we learn. We don't talk in the majlis. The kids don't talk. They listen. They will serve the coffee. They will take orders. And in the majlis, that's where we first had our model. There is a one specific person there. He is more maybe funny. He is more. We enjoy his story, and that's where usually we take our first model. As he's a brave, he's a falconer, or he's a seaman, or and that sometimes shapes our hobby. If that person is a diver, that's what we will wish to do, just to copy him. So Majlis was very important. Unfortunately, of course, the complexion of our lifestyle now had changed. And now we do have Majlises. As I said earlier, every house has a Majlis. But there are Majlises which are not used. It will pass a year and two, that particular Majlis is not used. But there are, of course, many Majlises still practice there. And the more simple form of a majlis, usually the more the majlis is attended.
Nice. Now to our audience, I think we have a question. Yes, please.
I would like to know, has Western influences and the affluent economic situation in Dubai affected at all the Majlis? And how does the youth of today in the Emirates respond to the Majlis? Do they have the same approach to it that you did as young people?
Salman?
Yes, it has actually affected. As I mentioned, the evolution of Majlis is, of course, were a reflection of how the society evolved here from the simple days of, as we saw, the Majlis on the ground, people sitting, eating together, a simple meal, to what we know now of a Majlis that has sofas and TV and the luxury of life. And certainly affected the way people talk and sit, and it's bigger Majlis now. So you really cannot talk or pay attention to everybody sitting probably at the end of that Majlis. TV also is playing a role there. People can sometimes watch the news. Not usually it is operated, it's considered to be rude in certain Majlises. But a lot of Majlises can see the news together. 50 men will sit and watch the news or programs of their interest. So that is that influence there of Western society or Western or modern, let's say, development. The young, I think, are affected by their gadgeteries. They have no time now to attend these Majlises because they probably have more interesting things to do. Unfortunately, they would learn a lot from Majlises, but it's life, and they have cars, they have mobile telephones, they can actually go into a younger Majlises together instead of sitting with older Majlises. Families, unfortunately, are not, or the parent, are not forceful as they used to be, and they do realize that there are more interesting young gathering than their Majlises. But they are not forceful to an extent where they'll have to have it as a duty to attend. Certain Majlises, yes, they do have their sons coming to the Majlis, for a period of time, and then they can go away. But I must say that because of the social change, the young are also affected by it. And Majlises certainly became a victim of the faster pace of life. I would go to a Majlis for 10 minutes to show a face and sit and talk and then leave elsewhere, because you have a lot of other commitments during the night than it used to be before.
I think we have another question. Yes?
The usage of the Majlis, it is increased in Ramadan days and Eid. That maybe you can explain much more about this thing.